Mick, congratulations. You said you wanted a devastating performance. Are you happy enough with that?
No, it could be much better. But listen, it's a in-the-box ticked first 12 round, their first fed Super Bantamweight against a tough, relentless wee opponent, and got the job done.
Yeah, he was. He was like the Duracell bunny, wasn't he? I didn't think he was going to stop.
He surprised me. Listen, but the guy's been in camp now for the same amount of time as me, sparring in the lakes of Nordino Bali and stuff. So, he's been really prepared for this. And, he showed that tonight. So, it was a very good fight.
And Jamie, was a bit of concern when the first score was announced. I think there was a bit of surprise where we were.
Worrying. It's happened more often. And I think Adam Booth pointed it out, and Michael also said it, that we are lucky that the likes of Pernell Whittaker, etc., are not fighting in this current day of age in British boxing, because how can you score shots that aren't landing or landing on the gloves, whereas the art of defence, whereas the art of boxing, this is a sweet science, and you're throwing punches willy-nilly and you're getting points.
No, fair enough. But like I say, I mean, he was game, the opponent. He was throwing punches in bunches, wasn't he? But you didn't seem like you were hurt by any of them.
Nah, I wasn't hurt. Listen, it was a great kind of learning fight. If I'm going to be world champion, I need to be much better than that. And I know that. I can see that right away. I'll need to watch it back. But it's the perfect kind of preparation, wake-up call, whatever you want to call it, for whatever's next.
Yeah, there was moments of world-class, world-class ability, world-class technique, shot selection, everything he was doing. And then there was moments that he has to learn look and study them even harder, because he was making silly mistakes, such as pulling out or going back in the straight lane. But that's all we small, minor things. This is not things that he cannot fix. These are things that are fixable changes that will meet. Oh, this is what it's a learning stage. It's all step and step. This is why he'll be world champion, because he'll learn from this. He'll get the red act read to him by Adam. Next camp will be very, very tough, tougher than this last camp because of this. And I'm happy with the performance. I'm happy that he didn't just blast them out of there. I'm happy that we got good 12 rounds out of 122 the first time it was made. Plenty of boxes ticked in it.
Well, I could hear you shouting instructions to him throughout the fight. Were you aware of that, Mick? Are you listening to what Jamie tells you?
I always hear my dad and Jamie's voices. So the three voices I hear is Adam, Jamie and my dad. So it's like, I can hear the instructions and I try to kind of do the right things at the right times, but sometimes you're just in the heat of battle, so sometimes they don't register, sometimes they do.
Yeah, it's very difficult. I mean, generally, I think you were happy. I mean, I could see a few smiles, when the movement, when he was slipping some of those punches, was amazing.
As I said, it was world class. It takes so much skill to do some of the things he was doing in the ring, didn't it? And then when you see a scorecard like that, it's mind-boggling, absolute mind-boggling. We watched a lot of tape of other fighters doing similar, Chavez, Whittaker. They were making people move and throw punches like he was doing with their feet. And Michael was mimicking that to a tee. But I don't want to rip into the judges too much, but we got the win, a lot to work on, but also a lot to be happy with.
And how is it watching your brother fight?
Horrific, absolutely horrific. This day 5 years ago, I fought Andy Nelson in the fight of the year, which was up and down, and I seen his reactions going crazy, and I just never want to be in his position. I'd rather be in my position going in them wars.
And you don't miss it being in there yourself?
No, doing that. I am nice and healthy and eating whatever I want. It's amazing. And no one's punching me in the face.
And what about you? You're still happy you're in there, though?
Of course. I'm only in it for one thing, to become world champion, and once I do that, I'll be happy.
And just finally, Carl Frampton obviously retired, not the way he'd want to go out. I know he's a good mate of yours. I'm sure he was watching tonight. Anything to say about Carl?
What a guy, what a legend, what a hero for Belfast and Irish boxing. He changed the whole landscape, and I think the next generation all inspired to be the next Carl Frampton. So he's a hero in the country.
He's the best Irish boxer ever. I think his record and resume is above and beyond everyone else's. And I'm happy he's retired now. Home with his wife, who is the gaffer, who is the boss, and I'm happy for him.
And with you, Paddy, Carl, all gone now, is it Mick's turn now to pick up the mantle?
We're in a new era of Irish boxing, yes, Irish professional boxing and amateur boxing. This is a new era, and Michael will carry the flag going forward.